ورحمة الله وبركاته. Boys and girls and my respected elders, welcome and أهلا وسهلا to مدرسة TV show. This is a show where we bring you مدرسة right in front of your TV screens. I'm your teacher for مدينة الأستاذ حمزة, and today I'm here to teach you a lot of exciting things. But before we start the excitement, let's start صلوات on the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, because today is Friday and Friday is سيد الأيام. Say with me, اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Boys and girls, welcome, and this is today is Friday. Today إن شاء الله تعالى we are going to be doing a lot of exciting things, and here are some of the things we are going to be learning. We are going to be learning some calligraphy, and then I will teach you something about the beloved Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And after that, we have a tajweed segment. And let's not forget the last segment, where we are going to do, well, learn Surah Al-Kahf. Now, I know a lot of you are not familiar with Surah Al-Kahf, and a lot of you don't know Surah Al-Kahf, which is absolutely fine. Then I will take you to the cave, and I teach you this surah, and you will get a chance to call and recite. So we have a WhatsApp number, we have a landline number, and I want you guys to call me in and recite and get some feedback, and it's going to be a lot of fun. Once again, not everyone knows Surah Al-Kahf, and if you don't know Surah Al-Kahf, it's absolutely fine. Call me in, recite with me. Boys and girls, let's start this show, and let's have a lot of fun together. First segment is going to be a calligraphy segment, and today I found a beautiful verse to write, and the verse is in Surah Al-Ahzab, and the verse is about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So let's go straight to our first segment, boys and girls, let's go! In Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us about the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam. And he says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. This is almost one line, a little bit extra, a little bit more than just one line. Just a little bit more than one line. Barakallahu feekum. So, what does it mean? Let's have a quick look at the translation. Barakallahu feekum. And here is the translation. Oh, where is it gone? I think I highlighted the long verse. Here. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's not the father of any one of your men, but he is the messenger of Allah. Wa khatam an-nabiyyin, yeah, and seal, last of the prophets. And ever Allah is Allah of all things knowing. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was the final messenger, okay? And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, did the Prophet have sons? Was the Prophet father to someone? Question. If someone can give me a good answer, I'm going to give you an extraordinary badge. Was it? Because here it says, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَى أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the father of any one of your men. Like, anyone. I thought he had sons. Is that true? Boys and girls, did the Prophet have sons? Let's have a look. Drop me a comment, inshallah ta'ala. And I want you to also send me your calligraphy on the number that you see right here on the screen. We have a studio line number, and we also have a WhatsApp number. Call us on either one of these numbers. Boys and girls, yalla, let's go. Let's go. Where are we going, boys and girls? Let's go here. Let's go. Bismillah. بسم الله. ما كان ما كان ميم فتحة ألف سكون ما next كان كاف فتحة ألف سكون كان ك and then you have نون ما كان next word محمد ميم ح ميم دال ما كان محمد Next word, not أبا but أبا. أبا أحد من رجالكم. ما كان محمد أبا. Next word, أبا. Boys and girls, we have our first caller of the day. Let's speak to them real quick. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام. الله وبركاته.
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
Okay. Maybe we can speak to the caller in a bit. ما كان محمد أبا حمزة با فتحة ألف سكون با أبا next أحد همزة فتحة أ حا فتحة أحا دال كسرتين دين أحد next من ميم نون من رجالكم رجالكم Now we move to next line. Now write with me boys and girls. I am writing one letter at a time. So calligraphy is really, really easy. All you have to do is to practice it. So let's practice it together. Next word, رجالكم. را ري جاليكم جيم فتحة ج رجا لام كسرة لي رجالي كم كاف رجالكم And now we add a massive arm to this calf. رجالكم Next, ولكن ولكن و ولكن we can't really write this word here so we are going to move to the next line ولكن well Very small, just completely. Well, ولكن this is lamb. Alif. Kaf. And nun. ولكن boys and girls we have a caller on the line let's speak to our callers before we take a short break السلام عليكم
وعليكم السلام
who's on the line
علي
علي how are you today
وبخير الحمد لله how are you استاذ حمزه
I'm very well الحمد لله you sound like someone who have a lot of plans for weekend Are you excited because it's Friday?
Yes, and alhamdulillah, the weekend is near. And guys,
yes, yes. Ustaz,
could I mention something?
Yes, please, go ahead.
Guys, do not forget to read Surah Al-Kahf before Salat al-Maghrib enters.
This is very important, guys. Let's not forget to read Surah Al-Kahf. And Ali, if you don't know how to read Surah Al-Kahf, what do we do?
You can call in and respond in... Recite and reflect segment and hear it out in the week segment.
Excellent, boys and girls. That is a very vital information that Ali is giving. If you don't know Surah Al-Kahf, then join us in the last two segments and learn and recite with us. Ali, do you know Surah Al-Kahf?
What part are we learning today, Ustad?
Today we're going to be learning the first part of Surah Al-Kahf, the first five verses.
Yes, I will try to do it on my own in the week segment.
MashaAllah, once upon a time, Ali didn't know Surah Al-Kahf. Second upon a time, Ali learned Surah Al-Kahf by attending Madrasa TV show, and now he knows Surah Al-Kahf. That is quite amazing. Is Ibrahim going to be reciting with you?
No, Ustad.
Okay. Maybe you can convince him. We still have two more segments. And so maybe take some time, try to convince him, inshallah ta'ala. Maybe he'll be convinced. And by then, we can get him to recite as well. And tell him if he can't recite, then we can recite together. What we will do in the meantime, can you speak to our, let's speak to the second caller in our next segment, inshallah ta'ala. Boys and girls, you're watching Madrasa TV show live. Ali is with us and he's going to come back to us in the last segment to recite with us. So why don't you guys go ahead, inshallah ta'ala, and call me in. Maybe we can have a little chat together and don't worry, I'm not going to force you to say and do something that you can't do. If you can't read Surah Al-Kahf, you will read it with me, word by word. It's going to be really easy. I still have few more words, ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. I'm going to write four more words, inshallah, and then add تشكيلات, and then we have loving the Prophet segment, inshallah, ta'ala. A lot of fun, boys and girls, on Madrasa TV show. Make sure you come back after a short break. Stay with us, boys and girls. We'll see you in a few minutes. Stay with us. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back, boys and girls. Assalamu alaikum. Madrasa TV show live on Iman channel, Monday to Friday, 4 to 5. And today is Friday. And because it is Friday, today we have a special segment called Surat al-Kahf segment. Bunny is covering this. But we also have a Tajweed segment, boys and girls. So I'll be teaching the first five verses of Surat al-Kahf with Tajweed. I want you guys to join me, recite with me, learn with me, have a lot of fun. But make sure you call in, inshallah ta'ala, boys and girls. Let's go straight to our second segment, inshallah. We have a caller. Let's speak to the caller before we go to the next segment. Assalamu alaikum, Iman.
Waikum assalam.
Iman, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
I'm very well. And how old are you, Iman?
5.
MashaAllah. Iman, are you going to be reciting with us?
Yes.
MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Iman, I would like to hear your recitation in the last segment, inshallah ta'ala. But until then, I want you to just wait with us, inshallah, and we will hear your recitation. I'd love to give you some feedback as well. Stay with me, and if you can't read Surat al-Kahf, we can recite it together. So don't worry about it too much. Let's go, inshallah, boys and girls. Let's go. So, we reached, actually, let's go back to drawing segment. So, where were we? Walakin, today we're writing this particular verse from Surat Al-Ahzab, verse number 40. مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ نَبَا أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ كان الله بكل شيء عليم. Verse number 40, barakallahu feekum, boys and girls. Let's go. Where did we reach? ولكن. ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. ولكن رسول الله. The word, next word here is رسول. This is ra. Ra. And then we say seen. Seen. After seen, we have, wow. Rasul. And the last letter here is la. Walakin. Rasul. Rasul. Walakin, and then Rasul. رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. رسول الله. Who got a badge? ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. الله همزة. لام. لام. ها ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وخاتم النبيين وخاتم النبيين. Two more words. وخاتم. This is واو. و خاتم. خا ألف تاء ميم وخاتم. Next word, النبيين. خاتم النبيين. همزة. لام. نون. باء. ياء. النون. ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. We'll stop here. And now you can, inshallah ta'ala, at home, finish this verse and write, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. But now I'm concerned about the dots. Let's add the dots here now, inshallah. Look, the word ma, really add any dots here. Kana, should only add a dot on top of noon. Then we have Muhammadun. No dots on any of these letters. Aba, a single dot underneath ba. Next, Ahadin. No dots here at all. Min, a dot on top of noon. Next, Rijalikum, a dot underneath jim. Walakin, a dot on top of noon. Rasul, no dots. Allah, no dots here. Wa khatam, khatam. An-Nabiyyin. In this word here, An-Nabiyyin, add a dot on top of noon, dot underneath ba, two dots underneath ya, and a dot on top of noon. An-Nabiyyin. Barakallahu feekum. Now, we add tashkilat. Fatha, kasra, and dhamma. And then straight after that, we can go to our next segment. Ma kana. Mim fatha with alif sukun ma. Next, kana. Kaf fatha alif sukun ka. Nun fathana kana. Next, Muhammadun. Mim dhamma mu. Ha fatha min shada ham. Mim fatha ma. Muhammadun. دال ضمتين دن ما كان محمد. Look at this. ما كان محمد أبا. أبا. Where are we supposed to put a Hamza here? Let me have a quick look into the Quran so I see the answer. ما كان محمد. Oh yes, Hamza on top of Alif. Aba. Hamza fatha. Ba fatha Alif mad ba. Aba. Next, Ahadin. A. Ha. Dal kasratain din. Ahadin. Next, Mir rijalikum. Mim kasra. Oops. Noon is empty. But now ra is going to have a shadda on top. Mir rijalikum. Ra with the shadda. And I wonder where we put a kasra. Underneath ra. Mir rijalikum. Sorry. Rijalikum. كاف ضمة ميم سكون كم من رجالكم ولكن واو فتحة واو لا تقول لا ولا كاف كسرة نون سكون كن ولكن لا ولكن ولا كر راء شدة ودة فتحة راء ولكن راء سين ضم واو سكون سو رسول لا فتح لا رسول ولكن رسول رسول الله همزة وصل لا مد شدة أنا فتحة هاك إسرائيل رسول الله نكس وخا فتح عليه سكون خا وخا تا فتحتها مين فتحتها ولكن رسول الله وخاتمه وخاتم النبيين. خاتم النبيين. من النبيين. Now this word is quite interesting. Look how is it written. أن ن بي النبيين. Have a look at it in the Quran. So let's try to spell it. همزة فتحة نون شدة أن أن با كسرة شدة بي يا كسرة يا صغيرة يي نون فتحة نا النبيين. Quite a difficult word. يا الله. So we have two ya's here. Only if you pay attention, you would see it. النبيين. النبيين. No. Barakallahu feekum, boys and girls. This will be the end of calligraphy segment. May Allah bless you. And let's go to our next segment. Before I take you there, if you practice calligraphy with me, don't just keep it to yourself. Send it to me on the WhatsApp number that you see here so I can give you some feedback on your work. And also, I can maybe give you a badge. Well, definitely give you a badge. So send me your work, inshallah, ta'ala, boys and girls. Send me your work on WhatsApp number. Let's take you to our Love in the Prophet segment. Let's go. Let's start this segment with a beautiful introduction, a verse from Quran. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul in kuntum tuhibbuna Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum wallahu ghafurur rahim. Isn't it true, boys and girls, that we all want to love Allah and we want Allah to love us? How do we do that? Allah says in the Quran, say, Prophet, to people, if you sincerely love Allah, then follow the Prophet. The follow me, the Prophet. Allah will love you and He'll forgive your sins. And Allah is all forgiving and He is the most merciful one. Allahu Akbar. We learn 3 points from this particular ayah. We all want to love Allah and Allah to love us. How? Here's the first point. We need to love and follow the Prophet and then Allah will love us. So it is loving the Prophet and following the Prophet that will gain us love of Allah Azza wa Jal. Next point. The Prophet has taught us all good deeds that make us closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. Next, following the Prophet's teaching is one of the conditions for deed to be accepted along with sincerity to Allah. So you must follow the Prophet for your deeds to be accepted. And here the Prophet taught us all the important sunnah, things that you should do so you can live the best life, inshallah ta'ala. It's very important that you remember that. Boys and girls, let's go to next part. And that is love. Loving the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is a reflection of what? Of your faith. Is it? If I love the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, will increase my faith, does it? We'll be back after a short break. We'll continue this segment and then we have Surah Al-Kahf segment, boys and girls. You're watching Madrasa TV show live on Iman channel. The show is live Monday to Friday. We'll be back after a short break to continue. We have a lot to learn and we have a lot of fun, inshallah ta'ala. But make sure you come back after a short break. If you haven't called me in to reside, call me in. The number is on the screen. We have a WhatsApp number. We have a landline number. Call us on any one of these numbers and I'll answer the phone and listen to your recitation. We'll be back after a short break. Stay with us. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back, boys and girls, to Madrasa TV show. This is going to be our final segment. Is it our final segment? Ah, Bunny forgot to tell me. Is it? Boys and girls, we are going to, inshallah ta'ala, listen to your recitation, also give you some feedback on your recitation. Let's finish this interesting segment on loving the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam first. If you want to recite, the number is on the screen. Give us a call, recite with us. So, how is it that the loving Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is a reflection of your faith? Have a look at this, boys and girls. None of you will have faith till he loves me more than his father, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, telling us a hadith. None of you will have faith until he loves me more than his father, his children, and all mankind. And boys and girls, this is a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. Isn't it interesting? Your relationship with your children, with your father, and everyone else, how do you maintain that? Following the sunnah of the Prophet, the way of the Prophet. If you don't value this, if you don't see this as anything, then how would you even hold any yourself accountable to relationship that you have with your father or children or rest of the people? You would say, I don't care about anyone. So here guidance becomes, this hadith shows us the importance of guidance, that the person who put us the guidance, through who the guidance came, the Prophet ﷺ, have to be more important and beloved to you, your father, than your children, rest of the mankind. Barakallahu feekum. Sleeping and waking up early. This is the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. If they love the Prophet, then you follow his sunnah. Our sleep plays a great role in our ability to do things well during the day. The hours after Fajr are among the most blessed of the day. That is early morning. Which hours are the most blessed hours of the day after Fajr? Now pay attention. Aisha said about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to sleep early at night and get up in the last part to pray, and then return to his bed. Allahu Akbar, boys and girls. Isn't this amazing? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to sleep early at night, get up in the last part to pray, and then return to his bed. Allahu Akbar. Break the cycle today. Wake up early and sleep early to be strong, successful, and blessed. This is something really, really important. SubhanAllah, sometimes you find it easy to put kids to bed or babies to bed. And we say, oh yeah, kids have to go to bed early. As soon as the sun, what about adults? You would rather go to sleep straight after Salat al-Isha and then wake up just before Fajr to pray Tahajjud than wasting your time, I don't know, doing what? What would you do? Watching something? No, that's not what you should do. Next. Something about the beauty of the beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, boys and girls. The messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was so clean, clear. This is by Abu Huraira, he's saying. He was so clear, clean, clear, beautiful and handsome, as though his body was covered and molded in silver. Allahu Akbar. His hair was slightly curled. So they were not straight hair, they were curly hair, slightly wavy. Allahu Akbar. Boys and girls, this was the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and the other hadith where we learn the meaning here, as though his body was covered and molded in silver, it means as if there was like, it was shining. That's how the Prophet looked like. Allahu Akbar. Boys and girls, we're now going to go to our final segment to learn Surah Al-Kahf. I urge you to call in and recite. But let's go to the next segment. First, we learn some tajweed rules and then I can take you to the cave. Boys and girls, we're looking at the first 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf. Let's go. First 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf together. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. With me. الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وينذر الذين قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا ما لهم به من علم ولا لآبائهم كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا فلعلك باخع نفسك على آثارهم إن لم يؤمنوا بهذا الحديث أسفا إنا جعلنا ما على الأرض زينة لها لنبلوهم أيهم أحسن عملا وإنا لجاعلون ما عليها صعيدا جرزا. We'll stop at verse number 5, بارك الله فيكم. Let's go. الحمد لله الذي. Four counts. الذي. أنزل على عبده ال That is a bouncing letter. عبده ال كتاب ولم يجعل يجعل له عوجا قيمل قيمل لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدنه ويبشر المؤمنين ويبشر المؤمنين ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات full mouth letter also whispering letter أن لهم غنة أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وينذر الذين قالوا نكالوا قالوا قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا ما لهم به من علم ولا لآبائهم كبرت كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم يقولون guys it's أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا We'll take our first caller. Let's go to the cave first. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. كيف حالك؟
Very well and how are you?
وبخير الحمد لله أستاذ
Yes
If I go past the ayah that you said that we're going to stop up to is that okay?
We have to stop at ayah number 5 because we got another caller but let's get you to recite inshallah ta'ala You can recite from ayah 6 next week
Okay أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدن ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وينذر الذين وينذر الذين قال اتخذ الله ولدا
Yes, قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا
قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا ما لهم به علم علم ولا لآبائهم كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم يقولون إلا كذبا
Well done. Let's tick. Next call. السلام عليكم. Extraordinary. إيمان السلام عليكم.
السلام.
Can you recite سورة الكهف?
No.
Together. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
الحمد
لله رب
لله الذي Say with me. أنزل على عبده كتابا ولم يجعل
يجعل
له
له
عوجا
عوجا.
ما شاء الله, bronze badge for you. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless all the rest of you boys and girls. Remember to recite Surah Al-Kahf and send salawat on the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. We'll be back with you Monday, 4 a.m. live on Iman Channel, inshallah ta'ala. And boys and girls, look after yourselves. Those of you watching live on YouTube, like, subscribe. We'll be seeing you on Monday. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.